What's up, guys? Dog Polk here, and welcome back for another episode of Poker Hands. And today we're going to be taking a look at a high-stakes hand from live with a bike that certainly caught my attention. Now, for some reason, people, and I mainly mean fish, like to talk about pocket kings. Are they ace magnets? Should you lay them down in the face of adversity? Can they take the heat? Well, here we've got some deep stack poker, where we're going to find out exactly the answer to that question. So on that note, let's go ahead and jump into the action.
Cash game training. We've had a doozy of a game here tonight. Garrett here to 600, ace three of diamonds. Bill in the hijack, jacks, and Jackie with pocket kings. And Bill is just called here. We saw Bill lose a huge pot about a month ago when he played jacks very, very strong by, I think it was with a back raise all in against Andy. And here, he has just flatted Garrett's raise, and Jackie's going to 3-bet. I'm not saying that Bill is going to back raise here at the stack depth, but we did see Bill get involved with jacks against Andy. Oh, Garrett is 4-bet to 10,000. Look at this.
Our hand begins at 100, 200 blinds with some very, very deep stacks here. Now, when you're playing deep stack poker, you got to be very aware of what you're representing and thinking about balancing your range so you can't get into some dicey spots post-flop where your range is clearly capped. In this hand, the action kicks off with under the gun, Garrett looking down at ace three of diamonds. Definitely a hand you're going to want to raise here in early position because of its combination of equity and removal. Now, Bill Klein behind Garrett looks down at pocket jacks. This is a spot you're going to want to bump it up. Now, I know by raising, you kind of start to give away what your hand looks like. But the thing is this. When you've got high pairs and premium hands in poker, you want to be raising for value, knocking people out of the pot. And if they do continue, you'll be ahead of their range. You can start to work in some pseudo connectors and certain hands like that so you can have some strong hands on different board textures. But you got to get value. When you're playing deep stack, you can't be afraid to get value. It's the same game. You just have a lot more at risk. Now, I definitely don't hate mixing in a call. It's a spot you can certainly choose to do so. And I think by calling with a hand like jacks, you allow yourself to have a call range that can have some strong hands too. But you want to be mainly raising because of how far ahead of Garrett's range that you are with pocket jacks. Anyway, Bill does decide to make the call. Bill does make the call. Now Jackie looks down the cutoff at pocket kings, the second best hand in no limit hold'em. Now in this spot, you always want to raise. Calling here would be way too passive. You risk having a six-way live poker flop, and that's not what you want with pocket kings. You want to bump this up, get some value, especially some of the loose games that we've been seeing lately here on Poker Hands. You can definitely get away with some big sizes. I don't mind seeing anything in the $3,000 to $4,000 range. Those all seem fairly reasonable to me. Jackie decides that he agrees and makes $3,500 to go. We've got ourselves a pot brewing. Well, the action then folds around back to Garrett, and now with the ace three of diamonds here out of position, you're going to want to mainly fold and every now and then work in a 4-bet. Hands like ace three suited make nice 4-bet bluffs because of their combination of equity and removal against strong ranges, and it's also going to put both players behind a pretty tough spot. Bill is not going to be able to continue with many hands at all, and then also Jackie, if he's getting a little ambitious with some weaker bluffs, well, he's going to be stuck in a spot where he's going to have to fold or risk a lot of his stack in order to make a move. Now, in this situation, I like going with a size. It's almost three times the size of the 3-bet, which Garrett decides to go for $10,000 here with his ace-3 suited. And again, as long as it's every now and then from Garrett, I don't mind it. But remember, if you're doing this with your ace-3 suited, ace-4 suited, ace-5 suited, you know, maybe some ace-queens, like maybe some ace-10s or ace-jacks or ace-x suited, other hands, king-queen, it's so easy for your 4-bets to get a little bit out of control here. This needs to be a very low-frequency play where you mainly just fold. It's also worth thinking about the fact that Garrett's range now has to get a little bit specific, and that's also a dangerous thing to do as you get deeper. As you get some deep stacks, you want your 4-bets to primarily be good hands, aces, kings, queens, ace, king, hands like that, but you need to start to work together some other weaker hands as well so your range isn't so face up and you've got some combinations that can hit some board textures that might not normally hit you. Let's just say for a moment that you were very short stacked. Well, you wouldn't have to worry about any of that because you could just go all in facing this 3-bet and you don't have to sweat it at all. But as you get deeper, it's more important you have those hands in your range so that you can play well post-flop. Anyway, Garrett does decide to make it $10,000, and now this is where the hand starts to go off the rails.
So Garrett four betting to 10,000. Remember, Bill had just flat. Is Bill back five betting here? He's reaching for chips.
27,000.
A back five bet. Oh my God.
27,000.
Raise call with jacks. Three bet with kings.
160.
Four bet by Garrett and a back five bet by Bill. And it's really small. I mean, it's to 27,000. Jackie is up a ton here tonight.
Bill Klein's being put in a tough spot here. He does have a very good hand, pocket jacks, but the action's getting a little bit scary. He's faced a raise, a 3-bet, and now a 4-bet, and it's starting to be unclear exactly where he's at. Now, in this situation, I think I'm going to advocate for having no 5-bet range at all, and the reason is very simple. The only hands that can profitably 5-bet here are hands like aces, maybe kings, and then once in a while, a couple of bluffs, but even then, those bluffs might not be making that much money. And the reason is because card removal starts to play a very serious role, combined with the fact that you're three ways. If Bill does decide to 5-bet here and makes it on the larger side, well, what hands are going to continue against him? It's going to be hands like aces and kings. And when you have a hand like pocket jacks, they're much more likely to have these holdings. So you're not really able to do this then for value. You're not really able to do this well as a bluff. And whenever you get into situations where card removal is that important, I think it mainly makes sense to just call with your continue range. Now, you're not thrilled about this spot, obviously, but you still will have a lot of strong hands here. And by calling with your range, you could call with hands like 10s through aces, maybe ace, king, ace, queen suited, some very strong hands, and then balance your range out post-flop knowing that you have all of these very strong holdings. If you're going to play deep stack live cash, you got to understand something. Everything you do at the table conveys information. So you want to make sure that you have a range that's balanced in these big pots so that you're able to correctly play post-flop. Anyway, Bill Klein has other ideas and decides to just 5-bet this to 27,000 with pocket jacks. This is definitely overplaying his hand strength, and if you're going to look for some bluffs, I might pick some other hands. This is the kind of bet that maybe you get queens or ace king to fold, but tens or worse is always letting it go, and you're going to get action from aces and kings, in theory. Now over to Jackie, and I'm actually going to advocate for the same thing that I just advocated for Bill. I think Jackie should only call here, okay? If he puts in another raise, the only hands that are going to give him action are aces for sure and maybe kings. They are very, very deep. And so you're not able to raise as a bluff. You're not able to raise them for value. And if you're ever making a raised preflop where it's simply, hey, this is aces, you need to be balancing it out with some calls because it's not something that's going to get action from your opponents. And there's no way that you can blend together a range that makes sense. Now, in this situation, I think what Jackie should do is he should call this 5-bet from Bill with a range that's something like queens to aces, ace king suited, maybe some occasional jacks and ace king, but he should be looking to fold almost all of those hands. But here is the thing, and this is where live poker and people's mentality and all of this stuff people talk about, exploitation and no one bluffs and this, that, and the other comes into play. This just has to be aces, right? I mean, look at Bill. It's looking a little too comfortable there. And we all know that players who are a little bit older don't bluff, right? So this has to be aces. What other hand could it possibly be? This is the kind of spot where heroes can dig deep and find a fold with kings. And so when you're asking yourself, how can I up my win rate when I'm playing live poker? Do I have to play that dumb GTO style? Or can I just get a read by looking deep into my opponent's soul and knowing he's got the aces? I'm going to let you guys decide by watching this hand.
Okay. another time extension. This all started with the flat from Bill with jacks. And a click back 5-bet here. Like I said, we saw Bill stack off to Andy about a month ago. Queens versus jacks with a back raise. With jacks. Here he's done it again. And it seems like Jackie is thinking about folding kings. I mean, can't you just call here and continue? I mean, he really looks like he's going to fold kings here. He does have Garrett to worry about behind him, and he's going to fold kings! Holy cow, what is going on here tonight? Garrett folds top set of jacks.
Sorry, Garrett, I was just laughing at you.
Well, I don't mind.
And pocket kings folds preflop like, no incorrectly.
Ah, it's always good to see live reads paying off. If you want to learn how not to be scared of everything when you have pocket kings, head on over to upswingpoker.com. We got plenty of courses that'll teach you just that so you don't make a huge laydown that costs yourself thousands of dollars.